Hi, it's Neva. Thanks for coming back and checking out my channel today. So today what I'm doing is the past videos I talked about adding new content to my YouTube for other parts of my business besides just wholesaling. So one aspect that you all asked me to include is my life as a realtor. So I thought, boom, I'm sitting here, I'm just about to make something to eat. I said, let me make a really quick video while I'm waiting. So on the realtor side of my business, what I do is I focus on pre-foreclosures and short sales, okay? So this video, I'm really gonna focus on the pre-foreclosure side, and I'll do another video talking about the short sale side. So for pre-foreclosures, how do I, as a realtor, handle pre-foreclosures, or how, I guess, my day-to-day life in the pre-foreclosure world as a realtor? So pre-foreclosures, for me, what I do, I focus on, these are properties that the homeowners are 30, 60, 90 days late. And I track and I get involved all the way from when they're first 30 days late, all the way up to they actually have an auction date. And basically for pre-foreclosures, what I'm doing is if the homeowner wants to stay in the home, I'm helping them by providing resources and tools and letting them know what options they have. Because a lot of times, the majority of people that I do contact that are in these situations, they don't actually know the options that they have. So just providing those options to them, and then if they, you know, it's just a situation where they just need to get out the house, it's just also helping them to get, I guess, the better options than foreclosure. Because I always recommend avoiding foreclosure, because foreclosure just has the most negative impact, I would say, of all the other options. Like, you know, and that's why I get into short sales, because sometimes people get behind on their mortgage and then they don't have any equity in the house. So they just walk away. You know, they just do like a cash or keys thing, and they think that that's really like the only option that they have. But what I usually advise them is to do the short sale, is because you can bounce back much quicker from a short sale than if your house actually forecloses. Because for instance, just one example, a short sale, you can get a mortgage 2 years later. A foreclosure, you're looking at 5, sometimes 7 years until you can get a mortgage again. So to just rebound and come back stronger is gonna take you much longer when you allow a house to go into foreclosure. So that's what I do. I just provide and let people know their options. And I love this side of the business. It's really busy because everything is so time sensitive. I definitely would say, you know, if maybe you're watching this and you're in that situation, because pre-foreclosures, the options that you have depend on, like, you know, how late you are. 30, 60, 90, is your auction date already? Can we get the bank to agree to stop the auction? So all of that is so time sensitive. So that side of my business is really, really busy. On the realtor side, I'm with Keller Williams, as you guys know, and I'm on the CAZA group. So, you know, we have a full team that also supports me, that, you know, can follow up and get things done really, really quickly. On the short sale side, we have professional negotiators that work, you know, and contact the bank. So, you know, it's a whole team on that side. I need to replace the battery on my, I think one of the motion detectors in my house. There's like a whole team of us that really work on that side of the business. So I really love that side of the business, because we're truly helping people at that point. These are people, you know, just something happened, sickness, death in family, loss of jobs, and especially here where I am in Virginia, it's like a little hub of highly intelligent people. So a lot of times when people fall behind on their mortgage here, you know, a series of just bad events have taken place, and that's why you're in that situation. And they're just really looking to, you know, just you know, they're just looking for solutions, but unfortunately a lot of times it's just not common knowledge what your options are when you fall behind on your mortgage. So day to day, that's what I do on the pre-foreclosure side, is really try to either, if people want to stay in the home, I kind of, you know, offer consulting and let them, you know, just giving them resources and tools that are available for them to stay in the home. If the decision is best to, they can't afford the payments, that they really need to sell the home, to advise them, you know, what would a sale at this point, what does it need to look like, what does it entail, what are the benefits and things like that for the different options. But always I'm advising people to avoid foreclosure because it's just so many negatives to it. You know, one, it's going to be hard for you to get a loan afterwards. If there's any deficiency, meaning if you owe $300,000, maybe your house goes to auction for $200,000, the bank can come after you for that deficiency, that difference, tax implications of it, you know, if that amount is forgiven. So those situations on the short sale side, those things are actually negotiated up front, as opposed to if you foreclose and then the bank contacts you years later about a deficiency bill. So I always advise people to, you know, I'm always trying to contact people, mail to them, sometimes I go to the homes to really let them know that they have options and to please, you know, avoid foreclosure. So I will do more videos. Like I said, I will do a video on short sales. I don't want the video to be but so long. But I was just sitting there, I said, let me, you know, I gotta come out and say hi to my peeps, right? So I'll try to, you know, get on here more and do videos. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I'm gonna come on and talk more about like my realtor business and what I do, what it looks like, and give you guys like when I go into the Keller Williams office, and you know, maybe I'll do some blogging actually, and things like that, so you guys can see. So you guys take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye. We'll be right back.